Imagine building a fully dynamic risk matrix in Excel using powerful functions like XLOOKUP without needing any special risk software. In this video, we'll create and share a dynamic template in Excel with four easy steps: identifying risks and implementing data validation, prioritizing risks using XLOOKUP function, risk rating in Excel using index and match, and comparing risk management in Excel with other risk software, including Primavera P6 risk analysis and Microsoft Project. You can follow along by getting the Excel workbook via the provided link in the description below. Stefan is identifying risks and implementing data validation. Our case focuses on a renewable energy project success. Renewable energy projects face a range of risks, including technical, environmental, financial, supply chain risks, regulatory, and operational risks. For each risk, the estimated cost of all possible outcomes or value at risk has been calculated in our risk register. Financial risks have the highest risk value of $1.5 million. Also, the owner of each risk has been identified, and as an example, technical risks are owned by engineering team. This decision is based on their authority, expertise, and ability to monitor, manage, and mitigate the specific risk. We aim to use our organization's risk matrix and prioritize risks to find the most significant threats based on their likelihood and impact. As can be seen, there are three values assigned to likelihood or probability. To minimize human errors in data entry, we can use the data validation tool in Excel and create a drop-down menu. For this, select the relevant cells and navigate to the data tab and choose data validation. Then under validation criteria, select list. Finally, specify the data source by selecting our defined likelihood values on the project risk matrix. As you can see, each cell now has a drop-down menu from which likelihood levels based on our risk matrix can be selected. We follow the same procedure for pre-mitigated impact or inherent risk consequence. Select the relevant cells again and navigate to the data tab and select data validation. Then on the data validation criteria, select list. Finally, specify the data source by selecting our defined impact values on the project risk matrix. The drop-down menu contains five possible risk impacts in our project context. An error message appears if you try to violate the validation criteria by typing a value out of the predefined list. Data validation in Excel with drop-down lists ensures consistency, accuracy, and efficiency by standardizing risk impact and likelihood selection. This reduces input errors and subjectivity in the risk management process.
Step 2 is prioritizing risks using XLOOKUP function.
We must prioritize risks based on their likelihood and impact using the logic provided in our risk matrix. XLOOKUP function in Microsoft 365 can automatically calculate priority levels for us. Click on the relevant cell and call XLOOKUP in the formula bar. The first argument is the lookup value, which is the likelihood of the first risk in cell E3. The second argument is the lookup array, which is our range of three possible probabilities in cells C15 to E15. We need absolute referencing or dollar sign since the formula will be replicated for other risks. We now call XLOOKUP again to find the impact of the first risk in cell F3. The lookup array is our range of five possible risk impacts in cells B10 to B14. We again need absolute referencing or dollar sign since the formula will be replicated for other risks. Finally, we need to specify the return array, which is our range of 15 possible priorities in the risk matrix. Again, do not forget the absolute referencing here. The formula returns moderate priority for risk 1, and by checking our matrix, this is a valid outcome. We can replicate the formula for all 6 risks, and ratings are calculated for us 100% automatically. Just a reminder that XLOOKUP is available in later versions of Excel or Microsoft 365. If you are using earlier versions of Excel, I'll shortly show how index and match functions can provide you with the same outcomes. May I pause here for a minute and quickly mention something? Our analytics show that around 30% of the channel's regular viewers are subscribed. If you are enjoying our content, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell. It's a free way to support us in continuing this learning journey. Thanks. Back to our template, and to complete the second step in quantitative risk management, we should color code the priorities similar to the theme provided in the risk matrix. We can do this by using the conditional formatting. Choose all risk ratings and navigate to the Home tab and select Manage Rules under Conditional Formatting. We must define a new rule for formatting cells that contain. We need to select the cell value, which is equal to, and select a risk rating such as high priority. Then we can format the cell and choose the fill color to be a shade of red similar to what we have in the risk matrix. By pressing OK, we have successfully created a rule for color coding high priorities. We must continue and generate new rules for cells with risk rating equal to moderate priority, and a shade of yellow is selected as the fill color. Finally, our third rule will be for cells with low priority assigned to them, and a shade of green will be their fill color. The color coding is applied by pressing OK, and the animation of our risk priorities is complete. The beauty of this approach is that if a new risk is added to our risk register, or values of impact and likelihood change, the whole sheet is updated dynamically.
Step three is risk rating in Excel using index and match functions.
For our risk register to be complete, we need to record mitigation actions against each risk. We start with the technical risks, and mitigation actions are using backup systems, regular testing, and advanced forecasting models. These align with industry best practices for managing technology failures and grid integration issues in renewable energy projects. These strategies are recommended to enhance system reliability and stability, as highlighted by the National Renewable Energy Laboratory's guidelines in the US. Also, McKinsey emphasizes the importance of advanced forecasting and planning to address the challenges associated with renewable energy integration into power grids. Implementing early environmental studies, ensuring regulatory compliance, and adopting adaptive design strategies are recognized as industry best practices for mitigating ecological impact concerns and preventing permitting delays. The European Commission's Joint Research Center identifies the best environmental management practices that help organizations minimize their environmental impact and emphasizes the importance of early assessment and compliance. Also, conducting thorough environmental risk assessments and maintaining compliance with environmental laws are essential steps in managing potential ecological risks effectively. Implementing mitigation actions such as long-term contracts, diversified revenue streams, and financial hedging aligns with industry best practices for managing financial risks in renewable energy projects. According to the United Nations Environment Program, utilizing financial risk management instruments like contracts and hedging can transfer certain types of risk away from investors and lenders, which result in reducing financial costs. Also, the International Renewable Energy Agency emphasizes that risk mitigation strategies are essential to attract private investors and mobilize capital for renewable energy investments. Implementing mitigation actions such as engaging multiple suppliers, maintaining buffer stock, and establishing alternative logistics routes aligns with industry best practices for managing supply chain risks related to component availability and material price volatility. Diversifying suppliers reduces dependence on a single source and minimizes the impact of potential disruptions. Maintaining buffer stock ensures operational continuity during unforeseen events, and identifying alternative logistics routes provides flexibility to navigate around transportation challenges. Implementing mitigation actions such as lobbying efforts, policy monitoring, and regulatory engagement aligns with industry best practices for managing risks associated with changes in government incentives and policy shifts. Proactive engagement with policymakers and continuous monitoring of the regulatory environment are essential strategies to anticipate and respond to potential policy changes. Establishing a compliance framework and implementing practical strategies can significantly enhance a project's success while minimizing associated risks. Implementing mitigation actions such as workforce planning, contingency scheduling, and preventive maintenance aligns with industry best practices for managing operational complexities and maintenance challenges. A structured approach to maintenance planning and scheduling and effective change management are essential for sustainable improvements in maintenance operations. In fact, the Electric Power Research Institute emphasizes that maintenance planning and scheduling are critical for optimizing resource utilization and minimizing downtime. To complete our risk register, we must calculate post-mitigation values of residual likelihood and residual impact. Based on our risk matrix, there are three values assigned to likelihood or probability. To minimize human errors in data entry, we can use the data validation tool in Excel and create a drop-down menu. First, select the relevant cells and navigate to the Data tab and select Data Validation. Then, under Validation Criteria, select List. Finally, specify the data source by selecting our defined likelihood values on the project risk matrix. As you see, each cell now has a drop-down menu from which residual likelihoods based on our risk matrix can be selected. We follow the same procedure for residual magnitude or impact. Select the relevant cells and navigate to the Data tab and select Data Validation. Then again, under Validation Criteria, select List. Finally, specify the data source by selecting our defined impact values on the project risk matrix. The drop-down menu now contains five possible risk impacts in our project context. If we try to violate the validation criteria by typing a value out of the predefined list, an error message appears. We must now prioritize risks based on their likelihood and impact using the logic provided in our risk matrix. If you are not using the latest Excel version or Microsoft 365, XLOOKUP is not supported. However, we can easily use index and match functions to achieve the same outcomes. Index and match functions in Excel can automatically calculate priority levels for us. Click on the relevant cell and call index in the formula bar. The first argument is array, which is our range of 15 possible priorities in the risk matrix. We need absolute referencing or dollar signs since the formula will be replicated for other risks. Now we can call the match function for which the first argument is lookup value. We must specify the impact of the first risk in cell J3. The lookup array is our range of 5 possible risk impacts in cells B10 to B14. We need absolute referencing or dollar sign again since the formula will be replicated for other risks. Then we determine the match type by assigning 0, which refers to the exact match of the lookup value to the lookup array. We now call match function for the second time to find post-mitigation probability or residual likelihood of the first risk in cell I3. The second argument is the lookup array, which is our range of three possible probabilities in cells C15 to E15. We need again absolute referencing or dollar signs since the formula will be replicated for other risks. We determine the match type by assigning 0 to find the exact match of lookup value to the lookup array. The formula returns low priority for risk 1, and by checking our matrix, we can see that this is a valid outcome. We can replicate the formula for all risks, and priority or rating is calculated for us 100% automatically. We should color code the priorities in a way that is similar to the theme provided in the risk matrix. We can do this by using the conditional formatting. Choose all risk ratings and navigate to the home tab and select manage rules under conditional formatting. We must define a new rule for formatting cells that contain. We need to select a cell value which is equal to and select a risk rating such as high priority. Then we can format the cell and choose the field color to be a shade of red, similar to what we have in the risk matrix. By pressing OK, we have successfully created a rule for color coding high priorities. We must continue and generate new rules for cells with risk rating equal to moderate priority, and a shade of yellow is selected as the field color. Finally, our third rule will be for cells with low priority assigned to them, and a shade of green will be their field color. The color coding is applied by pressing OK, and the animation of risk priorities is complete. The beauty of this approach is that if a new risk is added to our risk register, or values of impact and likelihood change, the whole sheet is updated dynamically.
Step 4 is comparing risk management in Excel with other risk software.
Comparing risk management in Excel with dedicated risk software highlights the trade-offs between flexibility, cost, and specialized functionality. Excel remains a go-to tool for many organizations because it is widely available, highly customizable, and familiar to most users. Its dynamic formulas, pivot tables, and conditional formatting allow for the creation of fully dynamic risk matrices and dashboards. Primavera P6 risk analysis is engineered for large-scale construction and engineering projects. P6 offers sophisticated risk modeling and simulation tools that integrate directly with project schedules and cost data. Its advanced analytical capabilities provide in-depth scenario analysis and Monte Carlo simulations in order to predict the impact of uncertainties on both timelines and budgets. Microsoft Project, on the other hand, integrates risk management directly into project planning. MS Project can track risks together with tasks, dependencies, and resource allocations to create a more holistic view of project health. This integration facilitates proactive mitigation as risks are visualized within the project timeline. This also streamlines the stakeholder communication. For organizations requiring advanced statistical analysis and regulatory compliance, SaaS Risk Management offers an enterprise-grade solution with extensive risk modeling, scenario analysis, and stress testing features. Its platform supports detailed quantitative analysis and makes it well-suited for complex financial portfolios and industries. However, the high cost and steep learning curve is not ideal for smaller organizations or projects with less complexity. Meanwhile, tools like Wrike and Jira are favored by agile teams and those who prioritize collaboration. These platforms provide real-time tracking, automated notifications, and customizable dashboards that keep cross-functional teams aligned on emerging risks. Their cloud-based nature facilitates continuous updates and dynamic reporting. Although they don't offer the deep numerical analysis found in Excel and SaaS, their strength is being collaborative and rapid response across teams. Finally, ProjectLibre serves as an open-source alternative for organizations with tighter budgets. It delivers basic risk management functionalities integrated with project scheduling and resource management. However, ProjectLibre lacks the advanced analytics and automation features of commercial tools. Its advantages are accessibility and cost-effectiveness, which make it an attractive option for small projects or organizations that don't need extensive risk analysis. For our renewable energy project, Excel is very helpful for managing risks with its dynamic templates, robust data analysis, and customizable dashboards. Remember, risk management isn't just about mitigating risks. It's about identifying vulnerabilities, implementing proactive strategies, and safeguarding project resilience with precision. Now that you have watched this video, you know exactly how to create a risk register in your future projects using Microsoft Excel.
If you found this video useful, please consider subscribing. You can find the Excel workbook via the provided link in the description below. I'll see you in the next one.